I think we'll have a further opportunity later in the week to discuss this issue, Taoiseach, because that's your intention.
Yeah.
Taoiseach, on... Sorry?
Yes, tomorrow, in fact.
Sorry?
Tomorrow, in fact.
Tomorrow, OK.
The pre-European Council statements tomorrow.
Appreciate that.
We'll extend that.
That will give us a good opportunity to discuss it. Greater. Appreciate that, Taoiseach. To return to domestic matters, Kion Curlell, last week, Taoiseach, and I know we're at the anniversary of the government and so forth, but I was in the North West and met many people there and was struck that 1 year on from the general election, people were still talking about broken promises that were made in respect of that area. As you may recall, during the election campaign at that time, the Labour Party promised that Sligo would become the ninth centre of excellence, while Fine Gael promised to return the service which had been removed to Galway. Minister Perry, in fact, went as far as promising it within the first 100 days of office, and that he would resign from Fine Gael if that did not happen. In Donegal, Minister Riley, as he did in quite many areas across the country at that time, he visited them in Lifford, and he gave very categoric assurances that the 20-bedded unit, quote, would under no circumstances be closed, and said its proximity to the border was one of the main reasons, unquote. Even though HICRA's report has said Lifford provides excellent care, the government 1 year on are announcing that Lifford is to be closed, along with another 800 approximately beds in the community nursing area across the country. In relation to home health, both Fine Gael and Labour promised more home care packages with additional funding to community care. Fine Gael went further to say that home care packages would be applied fairly and consistently across the country.
Question, please.
1 year later, 1,000 people will now have their home heads removed. Now, the people across the North West are genuinely angry and annoyed at the fact that there has been no attempt at all to fulfil the commitments that were solemnly given by your party, Taoiseach, and by your partners in government and Labour, particularly in relation to the ninth centre of excellence in terms of cancer care in the North West. I want to ask you, Taoiseach, can you indicate if that commitment is going to be fulfilled, and also the commitment in relation to Lifford Hospital?
Thank you. Taoiseach.
Thanks, Deputy Martin. I meet people from the North West myself on a regular basis. They are very consistent with a very strong programme of issues that should be addressed in the North West and that have been neglected for very many years. Both parties in opposition had particular views about a number of locations around the country. The programme for government is very clear here about the introduction of universal health insurance at the end of the lifetime of the government, about the introduction of very strong primary care centres and primary care teams, about the development of strong community care protection, and the provision of special facilities in particular locations. Government are working on that programme, and the question of the provision of adequate health facilities in every hospital is a matter that is always under consideration. I can inform Deputy Martin that the relevant medical teams who are looking at the question of smaller local hospitals, their future role, the expansion of services there, are in the process of completing that, and obviously that's a matter that will be part of public consultation about the future of those particular groupings of hospitals. In respect of groupings of larger hospitals with smaller ones, that work is underway by the medical and clinical teams, and obviously when that's finalised, the matter will become one for public discussion and obviously decision by government. So the question of your long programme of issues in the North West is one I'm intimately acquainted with myself, and indeed you can go to lots of other places around the country as well. You get equally strong views about issues, but suffice it to say that government's intention here is to implement its programme for government in regard to health. It's a challenging way forward in changing the structure and the decision process leading to best care and attention for patients, which should be central to every health programme.
Thank you, Taoiseach.
There's not actually a long list, and I would suggest that the term intimate acquaintance is the wrong definition now in terms of your relationship with the issues in Donegal, because it's getting quite hostile up there in terms of people's real sense of grievance about a breach of promise, specifically around cancer care and your specific commitment and indeed Minister Perry's commitment to Tánaiste's Fine Gael party to establish a centre of excellence in cancer care in the North West. That was a very solemn commitment given. I want to ask you, do you intend to uphold that promise? And will this government be establishing such a centre of care, a centre of excellence in cancer care in the North West? Yes or no?
As I said here, the Minister for Health himself was in the North West in the last 2 days and understand met a range of personnel from the medical profession across a number of centres up there. As I said to you, Deputy Martin, the government are intent on implementing its programme for government, and that programme for government is clear in the sectors I've already outlined for you. Government is now having the response from the clinical teams and the medical teams, a full cooperation and full flexibility as it makes arrangements to deal with the transition of significant numbers of persons from the health service who are leaving the public service as a result of the pension arrangements. Obviously, the government is fully intent on implementing its programme for government, which in this matter is very clear.
Thank you.